Two brand new stories in a special double feature, Casebusters and My Town, on the Disney Sunday Movie. Wednesday, it's a bittersweet reunion for MacGyver and his grandfather when both become targets of assassins on MacGyver. And now stay tuned for Laugh Olympics next. This is ABC.
Wrench!
Wrench!
Socket!
Socket!
Lugs!
Motor!
Tires!
Chassis!
Speed buggy!
That's me! Big race today. In my carburetor. Yeah.
Speed buggy.
Brand new stories in a special double feature, Casebusters and My Town, on the Disney Sunday Movie. Wednesday, it's a bittersweet reunion for MacGyver and his grandfather when both become targets of assassins on MacGyver. And now stay tuned for Laugh Olympics next. This is ABC.
Welcome everybody to RVT. This is RVT, Rasheed's Video Tube, in conjunction with RJC, Rasheed's Music Jukebox Center. And I am Rasheed, the R-Man, coming online on social media, Google, YouTube, and other social media platforms. Yeah, welcome. Guys, welcome to another edition of A Serial Picture Up, Rasheed's RVT Serial Picture Up, celebrating another episode of Linda Lisa is coming up within a week or so. We're very excited about that. Getting things off to a really cool start. I did something yesterday. I did another show yesterday. And I was bitching so much on I Threw It Away. I was bitching so much on it that I Threw It Away. So I figure I'll do a serial picture up. This way, I'm bound not to bitch and complain. How about that? Gotta do some food shopping. Gotta run around and take care of things. And this is something that,
God and man, your next breath will be as it were your first.
I'm a virgin!
Stop. What was it be?
She is no longer interested in catching what you're throwing, mister. Okay, everyone who hasn't had premarital sex gets ice cream.
Oh, dear God.
I love some King of the Hill, man. Anyway, let's get things started here with this serial picture up. It was a beautiful time, wasn't it? Yes, it was. Do we have any clips or anything? We still got, what's the name, right? Good. We'll show that. At least there's something.
Alan, drink your Ovaltine. It has vitamins and minerals.
Oh, do I have to?
It's got a new chocolatey taste.
I can't get over Ovaltine. It's so delicious now. It tastes fantastic. Wow, it's a whole new scene. Ovaltine. I can't get over Ovaltine. I can't get
over Ovaltine. The whole new taste you won't get over.
I can't get over Ovaltine.
Also available in sugar-free.
What's so funny?
We're eating funny cereal, Mr. Wilson.
May I see?
You asked for it.
We asked for more funny. You're asking for some fun.
Suddenly, your favorite funnies are all over a new cereal called Morning Funnies.
The fruit taste is wild.
A secret panel opens for more great comics.
Morning Funnies is a delicious part of my complete breakfast.
When you ask for Morning Funnies, you're asking for some fun.
Great, huh, Mr. Wilson?
At least it's something. Yes, at least it's something. Let's see. 80s. Oh, God. Give me a few seconds here.
Set free by the Teen Angels from his prehistoric block of glacier ice comes the world's first superhero, Captain Caveman. Now the constant companion to the Teen Angels, Brenda, Dee Dee, and Taffy in their hilarious and sometimes scary mystery missions. Get ready for Captain Caveman and the Teen Angels.
This way, up ahead.
Well, here we are, Teen Angels, in Dodge City for the yearly Wild West celebration.
Zowie! It looks just like it did in the days of the Old West.
Yeah, when they were cattle rustlers and thieves and train robberies and bad guys and...
Cool it, Brenda. Here comes the stage. Let's go for a ride.
Oonga bonga me, Cowboy Cavey.
Chef Dillard, here's the daily proceeds and the mail. Run it on down to the bank.
Sure thing, Mayor Wilkins.
Ah, yeah! Now's our chance.
This is super epic, riding in a real stagecoach.
Yeah, with real bandits. Look!
Look at me stop them, Captain!
This is all part of the celebration. It's only a phony robbery.
All right, this is a hold-up. Hand over the saddlebags. And don't try anything funny. I'll stop them.
Super Zowie, what a hero.
Thanks. Ridiculous.
It's hard to believe all of this going, you know. It's just hard, you know, and the thing about it is it kind of gets us, like, thinking, even kind of prepared of what can happen, you know. What can happen now? if this happened before, I mean, I don't see no, like the Holocaust. They say never again. The Holocaust is like never again. You don't see nobody saying no never again about getting rid of some shit like this. I don't hear nobody saying it, so it can happen again, dude. Like, whatever you're enjoying now. Won't they make it the news like that? Won't they do that? Won't they do the news like that? Well, what's wrong with doing the news like that? That'd be pretty cool. Yeah, so we only just have the main news is the way we used to have it. You know, we just had the 6 o'clock news, and then on Saturdays we had these, like, these, segments, prime time, whatever, and that's it. All the rest of the news, get the hell out of here. Why won't they do that? Don't you think it's too much news going around here? Don't you think it's too much? It kind of looks like it's too much. Bring this shit back. Can't you see this? Everybody thinking like this? This kind of stupid shit? Everybody thinking like this? Everybody is thinking childish stuff. If you notice, people, grown adults, are collecting toys now. You do not realize that. Not only is grown adults collecting toys, but they collected toys more than their children. I mean, you do realize that. Well, there you go, man. This thing's back like this. Get rid of some of the news. You don't need all that fucking news. Then they be saying the same thing over and over and over again. You know? It's too much news, don't you think so? Get rid of some of that news. Too much. Too much news. Too much news.
Drink your Ovaltine. It has vitamins and minerals.
Oh, do I have to?
It's got a new chocolatey taste.
I can't get over Ovaltine. It's so delicious now. It tastes fantastic. Wow, it's a whole new scene. I'm Ovaltine. I can't get over Ovaltine. I can't get
Ovaltine, the whole new taste you won't get over.
I can't get Ovaltine.
Also available in sugar-free.
Twisted mama, secret Lorette. Where's the table lover? Then and then clips. Now her hair, mommy, or ace. Anyway, we want to know.
I'm eating a couple of hamburgers, you know. You know, I'm glad we got that non-stick pan. Where nothing sticks to the pan. And it comes in handy. Nothing sticks on the pan. I think all the pans coming like that. I think so. Fucking awesome, man. Awesome. I came back from a scourging. I came back from a scourging. With my country box. And you ever just want to eat every goddamn thing? You know? Like, you just want to eat. You want to eat. You don't care. You just want to eat. That's how I feel. I just had a grilled cheese. You know what? It's probably because of this COVID shit. You know what I mean? Because of COVID. Nervous you eat. How many people gaining weight and shit like that? Shut up.
Kids like Kicks for what Kicks has got.
Moms like Kicks for what Kicks has not.
Kicks has corn and nuts and that.
Cause Kicks are gonna make fancy stuff.
No added colors.
Kicks doesn't need them.
No added flavors.
Kids love to eat them.
It's low in sugar so it's not too sweet.
A good Kicks breakfast, it's hard to beat. Kids like Kicks for what Kicks has got.
Moms like Kicks for what Kicks has not. Kicks, kid tested, mother approved.
Everybody's upset because it's COVID, I think. No, people are really upset. Because they see what is going there, you know? They see what everybody, nobody's stupid, everybody see what is going there. And nobody's happy about it. Nobody's happy about it. But not nobody can do about it. Nobody can do about it. You know what I'm saying? Okay.
This is nerve fencing. You get your source of
stop it.
That's my kid brother. Here.
Stop.
Anyway, this is a game of real skill. To win, you gotta have to all
stop parts. It.
Watch me demonstrate on the geek here.
What you want to eat, you know? Southeastians love food, man. And it's the shyster. It's like a trap. I want to eat. I ain't have a feeling for eating earlier than dang. I really don't know what it is. Now, a bunch of times I'm by myself, when it comes to you guys, I bet you I'm not by myself, man. But there's some crazy shit going on here. Who'd have thought? Okay, so here's some good stuff. You know what I'm saying, guys? Talk too much, you know. It's hard to put on a show. It's hard to put on a show nowadays. I'm being selfish. Want to hear everybody talk about spirituality? You got the nerve to say you want it to be good when you hear spirituality talking. You got the nerve to say, I want it to be good. Yeah, come on, talk that stuff. You know? Talk that God shit. You got the nerve to say you want it to sound good. Do y'all realize how hard it is to give a lecture right now? Realize that? But it looks so easy though. when you see somebody on stage talking about God, and it sounds good what they're talking about. It looks so damn easy. You have no idea how hard it is, man. It's so hard. It's so hard that sometimes I be thinking, I'm glad I not go there and talk like school. I think there's one advantage to being an adult. We ain't not going to school no more. It's like, that's what I feel. Thank God. Now, I'm a cult leader, and this is a new serving, my goddess. I said, I'm glad I got to talk that Bible stuff on stage. You know, I feel like that. And that's guilt. Because people need to hear that shit right now. But in the book of Revelation, they see they're going to want to hear it right now. The scriptures say, it says, seek God while he may be found. Because the day was going to come when people are going to seek him and he's going to be gone. He's going to be nowhere to be found. That's something to think about, you know? So nowadays, you got people dying to hear some kind of comfort in somewhere. And the people that's talking ain't satisfied. The people want to hear it. I don't know if it's on a level of seeking God and you can't find him. I don't know if it's on that level, but it is on a certain level, like people are not getting spiritually fed. Right, right. I do know that. Any cherry pie? Can I have a slice of cherry pie? I'm gonna get a slice of cherry pie. Hold on. I want a slice of cherry pie.
Alan, drink your Ovaltine. It has vitamins and minerals.
Oh, do I have to?
It's got a new chocolatey taste.
I can't get over Ovaltine. It's so delicious now. It tastes fantastic. Wow, it's a whole new scene.
Ovaltine, the whole new taste you won't get over. Also available in Sugar Free.
Cherry pie. Remember lace and all. These days will never come back, would it? I hated school back then. But just say any more of this stuff, man. That was the only bad part about it. Remember, you had school. Other than that, you enjoyed the Saturday morning. The whole thing was set up for us. The whole thing was set up for us. Everything. Let me see what's going on in this kitchen, man. I gave my mom some tuna fish. My dog likes tuna fish. Where was that? Well, you running anyway. You run ass any. Get your ass over there and finish your damn thing. Stop it. My dog likes tuna fish just as much as the cats. And I don't know if you guys have cats. This is my first time having a cat in about 10 years. About almost 10 years. And they changed. Part of Armageddon. Probably part of them. They're not frisky no more. They eating any fucking thing and scaring the fuck out you. But... because you're not used to seeing cats act like dogs and dogs act like cats. You're not used to seeing that. And yet, that's what you're seeing nowadays. Everything is switched all around, man. This is some scary shit, you know? But I'm sure that it's just part of the Great Tribulation starting Armageddon. Because this is some really scary shit. Seeing dogs act like cats and cats act like, it's really creepy. You know, cats ain't finicky no more. Now dogs finicky. And the only thing they got is the cleanness. It's the same. Cats still stay clean. And dogs, it's hard to give them a bath. That's still intact. That's still intact. But the other shit is really hard to deal with, man. When it comes to the food system, cats eating anything. And the dogs, the ones they eating shit. Like. Thank God the hygiene part is the same.
driver while you still have a choice.
It's just, y'all over my house. And, just sit back and relax. And experience that shit, you know? Ain't much to talk about. I mean, I'm telling the truth, there's not really much to talk about. If it was, I'll say it is, but it's really not much to talk about. I'm not going to sit in here and fucking lie to you. I could come on my social media thing and look on here for uploads, and I mean, the talking part of social media is going down. Yeah. I mean, it's like... I mean, if they are talking, they're talking about something. I'm talking just random talking. I mean, that's almost minute. Like, it's really nothing to talk about. It's really, you know. But that's who I am and shit. I like it this way. Because I talk shit. I talk anything. I really don't give a damn. I really don't give a damn. You know? I really don't give a darn, so I really don't give a damn. So I just talk anything. Long as we're looking at Rashid, you know exactly. Long as we're looking at Rashid, I don't give a damn if I come on here and be the visible man. Long as something on the screen is just denoting me, we're happy around here. I swear to God. Yeah, especially with these serial pitch-ups. I was going to do a doll one. Yeah. That would be pretty cool. I don't know when the last time I did one. That would be pretty cool. That would be pretty nice. Hey, I ain't got to. I don't want. It's nothing really, you know. Unless we're gonna talk doomsday shit, and I hate to be the doomsday preacher, or why she's a doomsday preacher. That's like, oh my god. Maybe okay. All right, I'll tell you what. You're right. Let's do it this way. There's a lot to talk about with the serial picture up. But I'm weaving it out because what we're going through in the world I don't want to seem like I'm from another, even though I am. I don't want to, you know, just relax and know that we'll never get these days back, and it's good we can come here and enjoy them. And that's what this is, you know. I was going to have something for this show, though. I just can't remember what it is, what it was. I can't remember what it was. I think it was cereal toys. I think that's it. We say we're going to do the cereal toys. This is found in a cereal box. It was something. Besides these little lace pictures, we're sticking in between this stuff. I'm just so pleased that we have another Ninja Lace animation coming up within a week or so. I'm just so happy we have that. Yeah. Pretty nice. Murphy Good.
I hate Smurfy Good. Rocky. Because we don't have COVID-19.
I know, we do.
That's too bad. I hate COVID-19.
Shit. Welcome to the universe, dude. It's just so ironic when you look at these commercials back in the day of so much to offer. But one thing you're not putting together is the fact you need money to get the shit. You know? You want to get it. You want to get it, but you need money for every damn thing. And back in the day, 75 cent was a lot of money back in like 1976, 1977. For a child to get 75 cents, that was a lot of money there. That's a lot of candy there. 75 cents. And if you got a dollar, oh, you was Willy Wonka. I swear to God, you was Willy Wonka if you had $1 in your hand. You gonna break that shit up, get 20 penny cookies? They don't sell penny cookies no more. They don't sell them. A cookie for one penny. You got 75 cents in your pocket. Oh my God. Could you imagine? You get like 20 cookies of chocolate chips, 20 oatmeal cookies. Then you get. You could get some 5 cent candies. Now, so far, you got 40 cookies in a bag. 40. 40. 40 now. Now you can get 5 cents worth of candy. You can get five peanut chews. So you got 40 cookies, 5 peanut chews, a hug, just 25 cents. And you still got change left over. Now you got 40 cookies, 5 peanut cheese, and a hug. All for 75 cents. Plus change left over. Fucking awesome, dude. And you can't get stuff like that no more. I mean, you got a bag full of just sugar. And all the friends in the neighborhood. You was Christ walking around. You were Jesus Christ walking around. How did you get 75 cents? That was America. How did you find 75 cents? What? Well, nowadays, I don't think kids come close to enjoying what we had. Remember squirrel nuts? I think they were a penny. Squirrel nuts? Then you get some squirrel nuts with the other, with the change. Get some squirrel nuts. Squirrel nuts is pretty awesome. Squirrel nuts are really fucking. You get a little brown. It was little brown squares. And it's hard to get the paper off that motherfucker sometimes. The paper would stick to the candy. But they were just so good, dude. They were just so good. I don't think they serve squirrel nuts no more. Chico stick was 10 cents. Yeah, Chico stick was 10 cents. Chico sticks are so good also. Coconut things there. 10 cents. You want expensive candy? You had to wait for the ice cream truck. When the ice cream truck came around, you backed up because there's no way you can afford that shit. That's when your parents had to come out and... Because there's no way you can afford no ice cream. They wanted $3 and $4 and all of that shit. They even served. And one thing about ice cream trucks that was interesting, you never saw nobody get a sundae. And they served sundaes on the ice cream truck. You know, real sundaes. Banana and everything. But you never saw nobody walk away with a sundae. You never saw it. They always walked away with a cone. Never a sundae. They never walked away with a sundae for Mr. Softy. Kind of makes you wonder about that, you know? What do they taste like, you know? I don't think, even today, I don't think people are asking for sundaes at a Mr. Softy ice cream. They just get ice cream cones. They some cone-eating motherfuckers, I know that. When it comes to sundaes, yeah, nobody get them. Nobody get no sundaes. Some ice cream trucks better be careful this year when the weather get hot like this. But you hardly hear any of them because of COVID-19. You hardly hear any ice cream trucks because of COVID. You hardly hear, I mean, by now you will hear, you know, not now, you know, because of COVID. You don't hear none. You don't hear none. I mean, going out there doing that, you could get COVID-19. Going out there getting that shit. Got so many angry people here. That's how I'm trying to put up shows like this. Put a smile on our face somehow. Yeah, get us talking and thinking about some shit. Because so many angriness going on right now. So much, you know, and the thing is, you can't blame. That's the thing. You can't blame people for being angry. You just can't do it. Not really, you can't. You can't blame people for being angry. And they are angry. Going through this simple shit because of something so stupid. I mean, something so fucking stupid. That these grown people should have known better not to do what they did. It's just so stupid. and so many lives being lost and jobs being all because this stupid shit. It just don't add up to not being angry. It just doesn't add up to not being angry. You know? It just don't add up to not being angry. We are not going through some stupid crap like this. I don't even want to, you know, it's a subject that you don't even want to fuck with. It's so ridiculous. It's just so damn ridiculous. So, I try to, you know, do something on here. Well, this ain't now. We always had a serial picture up now. Bet your sweet ass on that. We always had a serial picture up. But it's kind of hard to talk. You know, it's kind of hard to... And I don't know how these people doing it. And like when you got late night show TV shows and shit like that, I don't know how they doing it. I'm sure they find stuff to talk about, and they stick it strictly to those things to talk about. But for somebody to just talk randomly, like talk radio, I don't know how they doing that. I'm having a hard time though. But yeah, it's still, it's their job to do it, and they have to do it. I'm self-proclaimed, so this is optional for me. But for them, it's no option. That's their job. And they really got to talk about stuff that people are interested in hearing and all that. And usually, they go to the news or Hollywood. And that's a piggyback ride. You get on there, okay, now we got something to talk about. And that's what it's there for. So you can talk about it. So it's not doing nothing wrong at all. It's just that when you had a whim like us around here, we don't want that world in here with us. Then what have we got to talk about? And what have we got, you know? And that's when it becomes like a, sort of like a dilemma. Like, what's going on here, you know? But we're not doing half. Like I say, I like it this way. Because I talk too much any damn way. And I'll find something, anything for us to talk about. And I really don't give a damn what it is. As long as it's Rashidable. I don't care. My opinions, my views on shit. Even though a lot of people can't stand it. You know. I have the attitude like, well, I can't stand these shit, so I don't listen to these shit, but they listening to my shit. So what is that saying? You know? Because I don't listen to none of that shit. No offense or nothing. I'm not interested in it because it just brings me down. Stop it! It brings me down. I don't need to be brought down no more. I really don't. If I be brought down any lower, I'll look beside me and see my balls hanging there, sagging down. I can't be brought down any lower. I really can't. And I ain't trying to look at my balls hanging next to me. So, cold water. I had some underwear. I had Superman. And I thought I was Superman, I think. And that's going back a long time ago. Even before I knew that I liked to be a broadcaster. I was always doing my artwork. My broadcast is stuck up for me. All I had to do is put the shit together and see it. The way I like my tape recorder and talking on the telephone. Broadcasting is right there. I think you gotta go to college to take up engineering to get a degree in broadcasting. To be a certified broadcaster. I'm not a certified one, but I am a self-proclaimed broadcaster. There's a difference between the two. But she is a self-proclaimed broadcaster, but I'm not a certified broadcaster. Those guys went to college and got a degree in France, engineering and stuff. But I'm good enough to certify one. That's better than nothing. No. I'm okay with that. It's just this is definitely a good time period, and these kids gotta know what it is, or they'll never know. They don't know all the fun we had. Of having our brains tantalized with art every Saturday morning. Hey. And this went on every Saturday morning, mind you. Every Saturday morning, without let up, for years and years and years and years and years. A lot of people have been sleeping a lot. So many things happen because of this COVID lockdown. Because we are locked down, whether you know it or not. We're going into a fourth wave. We are. And even though they don't say we're on lockdown, dudes, we're on lockdown. We are. They ain't even got us saying. And you know they're not saying it. But you know that's what we are. We put ourselves here on lockdown. We did it. Because they ain't going to tell them they want to go out there and crazy in the street for some reason. And that alone, everybody's red flag up about why they want us to do, you know. So basically, we looking after ourselves with the shit. Some places, some incidences don't call for it, so it's not done. It's not done. Yeah, so sleepy and so tired. And keep chutting, making footprints underwater. You keep making footprints above water, you keep moving forward. Then you look down and find out you're walking in place.
Starts out, lift up your head and shout, it's gonna be a great day.
Time to get going.
Kellogg's waits for you with vitamins, iron, to helping you have a great day.
A very good part of starting your bright new morning is Kellogg's way.
Loops or rice or snacks,
flakes or bran or jacks, with Kellogg's you'll start a great day.
Any one of these Kellogg's cereals is a nutritious part of this complete breakfast, and that includes milk, juice, toast, and spread. When you start with Kellogg's, we'll be there to help you say,
it's gonna be a great day.
A very good part of starting your bright new morning is Kellogg's way.
Kellogg's will help you say, it's gonna be a great day.
Santa finally walking in place. You get dipping and eat a couple of cheeseburgers and, you know, start dipping a little bit. I got my water here keeping me warm, so it's cool. They're bringing back WWF coming back. That should be something, man. They've been closed down since COVID. Now they're coming back. And the government busy telling people to stop doing this. Don't open up right now. This ain't a smart thing to do. And people study. They're not listening to the government. They're going to get all the words. All the words, man. What time is it? I got a few minutes left. Oh, I can't do the 90s. Saturday morning in the 90s. I can't. No, that's not my generation. Hey, that's not my generation. The 90s, I was a man. The 90s, I was married. It wasn't on such a Saturday morning. I was out preaching the good news of the Bible on Saturday morning. So I don't know what they was doing on Saturday morning in the 90s. I don't know, but I was a man married, and I was out in the service, field service. So if I stick to the 70s, I'm with that. So I didn't tell you about that. As far as the 90s go, man, not too much. Not too much. Okay, let's head on out. I'm a Chuck, guys. Now listen, Linda Lace be up in a week or so. I'll be up, though, and let you know about it. Congratulations, everybody. We got another Linda Lace cartoon coming up. Also, along with Rashid Cowboy. Very interesting. Talking about something very interesting. You don't want to miss it. Thanks for tuning in again. Stay safe.